Bethel Operations Manager John Hastie has called a safety meeting to brief his pilots on the extreme wind conditions.
Winds are kicking today pretty good, so double check your winds before you take off. Watch out for those crosswinds.
Crosswind is a wind that blows perpendicular to the runway, making takeoffs and landings very challenging. Often, pilots use a technique called crabbing while taking off and landing in extreme crosswinds. During landing, the pilot crabs by keeping the nose of the plane pointed into the wind on descent. Then just before touchdown, the pilot realigns the nose and lands.
It's pretty chilly out there this morning. Just again, caution about the winds. Vance had a good question a little earlier. Are we crabbing or slipping to the runway?
That was just for the new guy.
So.
The new pilot is a recent hire from another US state.
My name's John Koeppen, and I'm new to ERA, which means that I've gone through an apprenticeship process.
The apprenticeship process required John to fly with a safety pilot for the last 15 weeks. Today, as winds approach 30 miles per hour, John has his final test. If he passes, he graduates and can fly solo.
All right, go fly. Be safe.
Ryanair 503, best of ground, runway 1 left, taxi, Golf Charlie, cross runway 30, Charlie.
Takeoff check complete.
10060, left turn, 1 left, to Golf Charlie, takeoff.
Inside the terminal, a trainee pilot prepares for what could be his last flight with a safety pilot.
My name's John Koeppen, and we're about to go flying to Tuntutuliak. I just moved up here in March.
The reason I moved up here is simply because it's beautiful up here, and there's really no other flying like this in the world. It's just a unique job, and I figured this is an opportunity that I can't pass up.
I'm new to ERA, which means that I've gone through an apprenticeship process where I was in the right seat of the caravan. And after the right seat of the caravan, you upgrade into a Cessna 207. I had to get 1,500 hours before I could upgrade. Now I've met that, surpassed that, and this is the last flight that I'll be flying with the safety pilot before I'm on the line flying by myself.
My name is John Dronenberg, and this is John Koeppen's last flight that he has to deal with me as a safety pilot, then he'll be out on his own.
We're trying to evaluate the pilot to make sure that they exercise good judgment, that they're consistent with their checklist usage, they're making good decisions, and that when they get let loose on their own, they're not gonna have their head up their ass.
So how long are you in town for?
3 days.
3 days?
On John's final flight, he's going to have to battle the increasingly strong winds of Tuntutuliak in order to bring the Ivanovs home, all while being carefully evaluated to see if he has what it takes to graduate and become a solo pilot.
We're getting ready to let the rookie loose, so that's what this is all about.
All right, folks, we're gonna be going to Tuntutuliak. Please keep your seats and seatbelts fastened at all times. There's survival gear in the back in a yellow bag and a briefing card in the seat in front of you. You guys have any questions? All right, we'll be on our way.
Yeah, 00 Mike, runway 1 left. Go ahead, quick.
Let's take off 1 left, 00 Mike.
Wheels looking good, gauges in the green.
Are you gonna miss me?
I am gonna miss you, John.
I know.
I think I'll always have your voice rattling in my ears, though.
That's good, that's comforting.
Yeah.
As John approaches Tuntutuliak, the winds blow at 32 miles per hour across the runway.
That's pretty good here.
Gotta make an awful noise. The wind up the back of the front. It would be just reverse actually. There you go.
A little squirrely here.
Yeah. I just need a little more speed or hold the power just a little bit longer so they keep that rudder authority.
Yeah. All right, guys, welcome to Tunt. Welcome home. Thank you guys very much. Let me grab your bread. I made especially sure not to smash it for you. Thank you guys very much.
Blue bag.
Blue bag? I don't see a blue bag.
It's a green one. Light blue bag.
Okay.
Mine's a green bag.
Yours a green bag? Okay.
My name on.
All right, well, I think we forgot to bring him, so is it okay if we drop him off tomorrow morning? Tomorrow morning, is that okay with you, sir?
For Forgetting two bags is not hugely problematic, but John needs to be more aware. Out here in the bush, cargo is precious, often containing vital medicine and survival essentials.
Only one more lay to go, what could possibly go wrong?
Trainee pilot John Koeppen's final safety flight did not have a smooth start. He forgot the customer's bags in Bethel.
Can't believe you forgot the bags. I mean, I thought you were ready to be done with all the safety pilot stuff, but you probably need another week, huh?
Done another bag sweep before we got in the aircraft.
While forgetting the customer's bags might not affect the safety of his passengers, it's a mental lapse that could cost John his promotion.
It's yours to lose.
To have any chance at becoming a solo pilot, John needs one good landing. And he's going to have to nail it in Bethel's brutal crosswinds. However, if at any point safety becomes an issue, the safety pilot can take control, ending John's chances of promotion. John touches down with little difficulty, but it's up to the safety pilot to decide if the flight was up to the airline's high standards. If it was, it will cut his shirt tails, signifying his graduation to solo pilot. After careful consideration, Dronenberg has made his decision.
Hey, Owen!
When a pilot has their first solo, it's kind of a tradition to cut their shirt tail. He's brand new, and he's basically going to be a babe in the woods.
So you know the old tradition of becoming a solo pilot?
I feel you back there with scissors.
Cutting your tail.
Wonderful.
There you go. You're free.
Back in the day, in tandem aircraft and biplanes, you used to have your instructor sitting behind you while you were sitting up front, not side by side. So when the instructor wasn't there anymore, he cut off the back of your shirt to let you know no one's there. So you kind of got to be a good sport.
Now, welcome to the big time.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
After you did your solo flight, finally, did they cut your tail or over with a brand new one?
Yeah, felt some cold steel on my back, and I was like, I'm not going to jump. Because you know, I know you have scissors, but what, you know, what is this about? It's kind of funny.
Okay, have fun out there.